All right. So the learning objectives of the first session today, we'll have a look at the latest functionalities related to the maps, which have been introduced in the Android application, and how the end user or the community worker can make use of the plotting of the patient data on the maps for his day-to-day activities. And how to move around the different functionalities and options which are available in the Android application. Then we'll have a look at the tracked entity instance analytics, where basically now in latest releases, we're able to create charts for different data elements and program indicators to kind of see regular plotting of data, which is relevant in specific use cases, such as non-communicable diseases or child growth monitoring and other programs as such. So we'll have a look at that. So I'll stop sharing the presentation and I'll share my Android device screen for the demonstration. All right, so I hope my screen is visible to all. So we're using the same application that we had installed yesterday for our Android session. So we'll have a look at some of the features that have been added with respect to the maps. And just to give you a little background, so the Android application would display the map screen in both the events and your tracker programs. And there are different types of spatial information which you collect when you're entering your patient data. So yesterday, we saw that we could collect information regarding the patient's enrollment. At the time of enrollment, we were capturing coordinates for the patient. Which were getting associated to the enrollment. Then we saw that we were collecting information with the events as well. So even while collecting data for events, you can collect the coordinates for each event where you're providing the specific service. Then you can create your tracked entity attributes or your data elements, which can be of type coordinate. So you can create multiple metadata objects and you can collect information for coordinates in more than one ways which are possible. For example, if in routine disease surveillance when we do, so one is of course where the patient came for getting his or her health checkup, that is of importance. So facility coordinates do hold an important parameter, do hold enough importance there in terms of collecting that information. But the patient's residence, in order to see the number of space cases spread in that specific area, also makes much more importance there. So you can collect both these informations. You can collect, say, the facility enrollment facility coordinates through the enrollment coordinates, but you can create try identity attributes, or you can create data elements of coordinate type and you can name them whatever you want to. So you can say patient's residence coordinates or patient's locality coordinates. Okay. So you can collect information, and whatever coordinate data you're collecting in your program, you can utilize that data to see those mappings on the maps application. Okay. So we'll see what all coordinate types are supported in the maps application, and accordingly we can see them one by one. So I'll open the contract registration and follow-up program here to have a look at the maps. So when you click on the program, it kind of will load the existing list of patients which are there. In the bottom, you see there are two options. One is the list, and second one is your map icon. When you click on the maps icon, it will start loading the tracked entities which are enrolled in this program and their respective locations as well. Okay. So you see here that in this program, these many contacts have been registered, and these are the locations which have been set for these respective people. Okay. So now you're able to see the coordinate location for registration for each of the contacts which you had registered. Okay. Now for each of the patient, if you click on the icon, the row, the arrow icon, you'll see more information. Okay. And as you keep swiping your data, the patient records keeps on changing. Okay. So now this person is from Bangladesh. The first name is Arif, was enrolled in CHW Mahasod. And this was the details for that specific patient. And this was the coordinates which are captured for this patient while registration. So you can see the coordinates and the country of residence for each person who has enrolled into the program. Okay. Now let's go back. Now, what you can do is when you are scrolling through each of the tab, you kind of are getting access to each of the person's profile. Okay. So what you can do is if you want to access this person now, you click on the patient card and it will take you to the patient dashboard. Okay. So now from the Maps app, you were able to reach out to the person's dashboard in the contact registration and tracing to the contact tracing program. Okay. So this way you can reach out to specific profiles through the maps mapping which has been done for the contacts in the Android application. Okay. So you can switch through the cards. Each of the card is one specific person. If you want more information for that specific person, you can take the arrow up and down. Or if you want to see this person's dashboard, then you click on this particular card and it will redirect you to this person's information. So you can see further information that has been filled for this person. Okay. So this is the way you can access the tagged entity instances in a program through the mapping of the coordinates when you were registering this person into the program. Okay. Now you see there is a circle and U is written in that. So this is basically a placeholder for the image of that respective person. So in case you are also capturing the images of the patients that you're registering, so in place of this U icon, you'll see the image of the person here. So you can also collect images while registering the person, and those images will be shown here if you're collecting the images as well. Okay. So that's one of the feature which is there. Now, in this respective area in the Android application, now you have this navigation icon available here. Okay. So while I was doing the webinar, I for the tracker features, I'd mentioned that there are use cases being where you need the integration of the location of the health worker and the patient's location. So, and it was much asked during the COVID use case that where many countries started home delivery of ART drugs for HIV positive cases. So they wanted to know that whether the app could facilitate them to reach out to those people based on their current location. So you have this arrow icon available here in the bottom right screen. So if you click on that, if you click on that, it will ask you to select any of the maps application which you use. And I select Google Maps from here. So then it will take the coordinates of the patient which are there in the system. And based on your current location, it can give you the directions of how to reach that specific person. So considering a scenario that you have captured information for a patient for his residence, and now you want to visit the patient's residence from your current location, so you can use the default directions feature in Google Map to reach out to this respective person's residence and give him the required services. Okay, so the integration with the Maps application has been added now, so that's available for use. Okay, so this is one new feature which has been added to kind of integrate the patient's location and use any of your mapping apps available, a Maps app which you use either. Basically, most of us use Google Maps on Android platform, so that's now integrated with the Google Map function, and you could always see the distance and the directions from your location and the person's location as per the information stored in the database. Okay. Then there are two icons on the top on the left top corner. One is the current location icon. So if you want to see your current location, then you can click on that, and a blue icon will show you the current location. So presently I'm in New Delhi, so it shows a blue dot over New Delhi. So that is, you can always see your current location with respect to the geography where you are. Second information which you can see is, so if I go back and let the, so I'll go back to the program and let the patient coordinates load to see the cluster of patients which are set in the contact registration program. Then I'll show you how you can use the map layers. So the map layers which you see would basically be depending upon the configuration of the program in terms of what kind of coordinates you're capturing. So are you capturing the coordinates for TEI? Are you capturing the coordinates with enrollment, with each event, with relationships? So you can do accordingly. So if you click on the top icon for layers, you'll see the kind of coordinates which you can plot based on how your program has been configured and whether the data is available for these respective layers or not. Okay. So for example, you want to see the coordinates of your tagged entity instance, and you also want to see the relationship between each of the contacts which are there. Okay, so I select has been in contact with, and I selected show TEI coordinates, and I click on apply. So you see, if I zoom in, then you see there are these purple arrows. That means that these patients which you see are bound by relationship in the system. So these are kind of the contacts of each of the patients which are there in the system. Okay. So you can see that there is a contact between this patient and this patient. So if you go back and see this patient's card, you'll see that that's just Greg. And if you see Greg's record and you go to relationship icon, you'll see that this person is related to Angela. So in this program, this person got in contact through Angela. So likewise, you're seeing a relationship diagram between the different tracked entities who were enrolled into this program, and they were added relationship and had coordinates captured for both the contact as well as the specific person. Okay. So this is how you can use your TEI coordinates, which are the coordinates of the person you enrolled and the coordinates of the person with whom you created a relationship with them. Okay. Then you have a heat map layer as well. So if you apply the heat map layer, then you could see the kind of the coverage, or you can see the number of cases which are coming from one specific location. So then the larger the number of cases, the broader the circle be and the broader the intensity be, to kind of see in that specific way. And you can also change the view to satellite view, and you can change. So it will change your base map to a satellite view and remove the open street map, which is there by default. Okay. So you can do these activities accordingly. Okay. So this is how an end user can see the patient's location, can reach out to this person by using the Google Map integration, and you can plot these data on the layers, and you can change the views also between street view and the satellite view. So these have been the latest enhancements which have been introduced in the Android application, so that the person is able to use the Android app to make use of the coordinates data which you collect, because we can collect coordinates, but if not using them for proper use, then they make no sense. So that's why a lot of focus was given on making use of the coordinates data that we're collecting either on the web or on the Android version. Okay. And using the relationships also to see to one person is related to how many individuals and where they are located. Okay. So if there are any questions, I'll just check them once. And if not, then we can proceed ahead. Okay, so I don't see any questions in the chat box. Please do add if there are any questions on the chat box, then I can take those questions as I move ahead. So this was supposed to be a short session for 45 minutes. So I'll cover the topics I wanted to cover, and then I can take up the questions as we go ahead. So now we've seen the features of the maps which are available. We can now move to the tracked entity instance analytics part. So now you can see a lot of offline analytics or in-app analytics, what we can call for the patient data which you're entering in the Android application. So for example, we'll again select the contact registration and follow-up program. And let's try to search for a person. Okay, so I've searched for Carlos. I'll open this particular person. And below, you see there's an icon for analytics menu, the second icon. So you click on that. And you'll see that it has a mapping of the weight of this person, which was taken at different intervals. Okay. So now weight is a data element which you were collecting, and weight is collected in different visits that I make. So then for key variables which you collect and which could be plotted, basically, or any value which is of type number, and it does make sense to plot, then it gets collected at repeated intervals. So the app will automatically start plotting that data and show you the trends of that specific information at each visit. Okay. So the example is not directly related to COVID-19, but then since we're using this database, we thought of showing you some samples of the feasibilities which are there within the Android application. But had this program been configured for RMNCEH or nutrition related programs, then this functionality would have made much more sense, where you're able to see the progression of the weight of a pregnant woman or progression of a weight for a child if you're doing growth monitoring. So this kind of is offline. As you enter data, the charts get updated. through the data which is entered into the Android application. So you can use these in-app analytics to check the data and the progression of the data elements and the information which you're capturing. Now you see there is an ellipse icon available here. You can click on the icon and you can change the view as well. You can view it as a bar, you can view it as a table, or you can view it as a value. Okay, so this value will be from the latest event which has happened. So if I have come 3 times and I have gotten my weight measured on each visit, then this will show me for the latest visit. Okay, then I can also put a period. So if I want to see monthly and last 3 months, and then it asks me if I want to include the current period, I'll do that yes. So it will show me a month-wise progression as well. So there is a lot of in-app filters which I can put for this respective chart and keep it updating so that I can see period-wise information also. And I can see trends and tables and values as I wish to. Okay. So this is one of the new features that has been added for the in-app analytics or offline analytics. Now let's see how the program indicators are used. So the last data which you saw was coming from data elements. So weight was captured at each visit and that was getting plotted. Now we saw that there are indicators which can be plotted and shown on the data entry screen in the Tracker Capture app. So we saw in the indicators widget that we were showing indicators for age, we were showing indicators for allergies, we were showing indicators for past medical history. So the same concept applies to the Android application also. So let's search for a patient again, and let's try to see some information which is stored against that respective patient. So we have a look at Matthew, whose information is already pre-fed into the system. So I don't search them. Let's check again. COVID case-based surveillance program. For okay, I open the record and I go to the stage 3. I look at the latest visit. I go to analytics panel. So I see the indicators being shown here. So I see the patient's age and I see the total number of tests that had been done for this respective person. So this was the first testing event. So it shows as 1. If I go back and look at the second event which was added, okay, and I again go back to the analytics tab, it shows me the number of tests which were done in each event and the age of that respective person. So these are basically program indicators which are being shown on the respective analytics widget. So if you happen to create program indicators in your program, then, and you have selected the property to display on the form, so when you see those indicators on the indicators widget on the web app, you can also see the same indicators on the analytics section on the Android app as well. Okay, so this is how we can use program indicators. Then we can also have a look at how the plotting or tracking of other data could be seen. So let's go to the COVID vaccination program and see a couple of more examples. So let me search for a specific person. And I'll go to their analytics page. Okay, So I see that there are a summary information is given here that the age of the patient is 36. She is a health worker and she has renal disease as a risk factor. And then she, the total number of doses which are required for this product is 2. So that's added there. So likewise, it currently picks up whatever information that can be plotted, and it might not make sense for all the information. So presently in the new releases, which are due in next few weeks, we have added filters that on your in-app analytics dashboard in the Android, what information do you want to show, what do you want to hide? So you can always take and select key parameters which you want to show on the Android application on in the analytics section, and the ones you want to hide, you can hide them. Okay. So right now it kind of shows for all the number type of data elements which are repeated across events, and the values can be traced. But we will soon release the new app, which will have the functionality for the user to choose that what data he wants to see on the analytical dashboard for this person and what data he doesn't want to see. Okay. So these were the some of the new functionalities which are available on the Android application. So the idea was to introduce you guys to the new developments which are happening with respect to Android data collection and making the app rich in terms of in-app analytics, which was missing from the previous versions because the previous versions were more focused on data collection. But now the end user could make use of that data which the end user is collecting by the aggregation and also the plotting of the data and its evolution over time. So this could be done. The more fit use cases that we see in future that would be used would be the RMNCH program, where you're tracking mother's hemoglobin, mother's weight in on her succession of ANC visits. Then you have childbirth monitoring. Now the system can also calculate these anthropometric measures for Z scores, weight for height, weight for age, and length for age. So those are automatically plotted. So if your program has program rules and indicators for Z scores, then automatically the app will start producing the growth charts based on the standards and the directions given by the WHO. So those are being followed. So hopefully this section will evolve in the upcoming academies, and we'll have more relevant examples, and we're working on creating databases which could give you a better view of the functionalities and with the apt data for this. But then since this was the first academy on TrackerUse, we wanted to introduce the concept, and this session will evolve in much richer content information as we move ahead. So that was the quick session for today on introducing the Android analysis part. If there are any specific questions, please feel free to ask. I'll be happy to answer them. You can leave the questions on the Slack channel, or you can leave it on the chat here before we start the next session. I think we still have around 10 minutes. So we had allotted on 45 minutes to this session. So in the meanwhile, if you would like to quickly do the exercises which are there in your learner's guide, then you can do those. They won't take more than 10, 15 minutes. So please see whatever fits best. You can ask questions, or you can take 10 minutes to do the learner's guide exercises, and then we can start with the next session.